So we're going to have the words of Emily Dickinson, the music of Jane Ira Bloom, and the soul of everybody. Please welcome, and more.
Excuse Emily and her atoms. The North Star is of small fabric, but it implies much, yet presides. Thank you. Alone and in a circumstance reluctant to be told, a spider on my reticence assiduously crawled, and so much more at home than I immediately grew, I felt myself a visitor and hurriedly withdrew. Thank you. One note from one bird is better than a million words. A scabbard needs, has, holds, but one sword.
Thank you.
lived on dread. To those who know the stimulus there is in danger, other impetus is numb and vitalless. As it were a spur upon the soul, a fear will urge it where to go. Without the specter's aid, we're challenging despair. Thank you. trees to note, not loud enough for wind, a star not far enough to seek, nor near enough to find. A long, long yellow on the lawn, a hubbub as of feet, not audible as ours to us, but dapper, more sweet. A hurrying home of little men to houses unperceived, all this and more, if I should tell, would never be believed. Of robins in the trundle bed, how many I espy, whose nightgowns could not hide their wings, although I heard them try. But then, I promised not to tell. How could I break my word? So you go your way, and I'll go mine. No fear you'll miss the road. The visit of the circus to Amherst in 1866. G.F. Bailey and Company's great quadruple combination will exhibit in Amherst on Friday, May 4th, 1866. The visit of the circus proved to be a singularly important event in Amherst, where very little happened to distract our attention from our work. We were all in a fever of excitement to attend the performance, to get from the railroad depot to the grounds where the circus pitched its tent. The animals and acts had to troop past the homestead. Due east of our home, the lively procession wended its way up Triangle Street. Friday, I tasted life. I wrote to Elizabeth Holland. It was a vast morsel. A circus passed the house. Still, I feel the red in my mind, although the drums are out. Thank you. felt a cleaving in my mind as though my brain had split. I tried to match it scene by scene, but could not make them fit. The thought behind, I strove to join unto the thought before, but sequence raveled out of reach like balls upon a floor. Thank you. Over and over, like a tune, the recollection plays. Drums of phantom battlements, cornets of paradise, snatches from baptized generations with cadences too grand, but for the justified processions at the Lord's right hand. Introduce ourselves to planets and to flowers. But with ourselves have etiquettes. Embarrassments. Thank you. Going to him, happy letter. Tell him the page I didn't write. Tell him I only said the syntax and left the verb and the pronoun out. Tell him just how the fingers hurried. Then how they waited slow, slow, slow. And then you'll wish you had eyes in your pages so you could see what moved them so. Thank you. never felt at home below, and in the handsome skies I shall not feel at home, I know. I don't like paradise, because it's Sunday all the time, and recess never comes, and Eden will be so lonesome bright Wednesday afternoons. take all away from me, but leave me ecstasy, and I am richer then. It's a joy to be with you, because near, we love you.
Allison Miller, Mark Elias, John Clement, Deborah Rush, and Jane Ira Bloom.